goes without saying that Industry 4.0 and Industrial Ethernet are changing a whole lot of things. But most importantly, for us in electronic engineering, they are creating a whole new class of systems, connected equipment, and devices. But in order for all of these pieces to communicate effectively and efficiently together, we need to do away with our old communication methods. And one of the most important aspects of doing away with the old and bringing in the new includes our choice of connectors. Hi, I'm Amelia Dalton, host of Chalk Talk. No longer are hierarchical communication models effective in this new era of Industry 4.0. We need to look at an independent communication model that includes a single network with industrial Ethernet at its core. In this episode of Chalk Talk, Peter Swift from Amphenol joins me to discuss the SPE and IX industrial family of connectors from Amphenol. We take a closer look at the details of these connector solutions and why they are a great fit for the next generation of industrial automation applications. And before we get started, don't forget to click that link. There you can find even more information about this topic from Amphenol. Hi, Peter. Thank you so much for joining me.
Hi, Amelia. Thank you for having me.
Absolutely. Okay, so we're talking about next generation connectors for industrial Ethernet today. But Peter, before we get started, can you set the stage for us? What kind of trends are you seeing in this space in particular?
Well, the factory and process automation segments of the industrial market are being driven by a number of trends and specific needs, all of which are related to increasing consumer demand, product quality, lead time to market, and reduction of cost. These drivers create a requirement for more automation, real-time process control, zero-defect manufacturing, and efficiency improvements with the goals of faster, better, and less expensive. Automation requires communication between devices, and this has evolved from simple to more complex and sophisticated technologies. And as a result of specialization and natural competition in the market, many different communication interfaces and protocols have developed. The Industrial Internet of Things is a natural extension of IoT, enabling factory equipment and systems to interact with each other and the outside world of suppliers, customers, logistics, etc. Also known as Industry 4.0, this is the next industrial revolution. Growth in communication and intelligence exposes a number of gating factors, and one of these is protocol. As independent subsystems and networks have developed within the manufacturing hierarchy, many different communication protocols have been created. As data volume increases, so does the need for these various networks to be able to talk to each other efficiently and accurately. A single communication protocol solves a lot of problems. Increasing data volume drives the speed of communication, or the data rate between devices and their corresponding control systems. As the number of interconnected devices grows, so does the need to scale accordingly so that the limits of any one network do not impact the overall system. This growth in the number of devices also creates the need for more connections. And with shrinking equipment size, port density has to increase, so more compact interconnect systems are needed. Manufacturing plants can be harsh environments with lots of moving machinery, and environmental factories like temperature, humidity, moisture, and physical vibration and shock. Ruggedized form factors and design elements are needed to function reliably in such environments. As the number of sensors and other devices increases, efficient power delivery is critical. Devices have typically been powered by separate sources, but this has become more challenging, so technology is needed to power the devices over the data lines connecting them. Increasing speeds and complexity drive the need for more data analysis to adjust system parameters and the ability to identify and predict issues in real time. And because there is a lot of existing manufacturing plants that will need to adopt and adapt new systems into their existing ones, it's essential for new equipment and protocols to talk to old heritage equipment.
So, Peter, Ethernet protocol varies across the different industries, right?
Absolutely. There are a number of different types of Ethernet, with the various flavors based on operating speed and the type of media being used, but all versions of Ethernet are compatible with each other. It is being used across a wide spectrum of industries, and Ethernet is rapidly being adopted as the protocol of choice in industrial automation systems as well. Ethernet was invented in 1973. And the first published standard in 1980 provided 10 megabit performance. Since then, the standards have covered bandwidth growth to 100 megabit, 1 gig, 10 gig, and 40 to 100 gigabit Ethernet. The evolution for 200 gigabit Ethernet and 400 gigabit Ethernet is unfolding now.
That's exciting. Now, Peter, what are we looking at when it comes to industrial Ethernet protocol in particular?
Well, the industrial automation and building automation space operates at the lower end of the spectrum at up to 10 gigabit Ethernet, and Ethernet adoption in this market has been relatively slow, mainly because automation processes and equipment themselves have not been particularly demanding in terms of data rate. However, Industry 4.0 is changing this, and the rapid and widespread adoption of industrial Ethernet standards is enabling the development of a whole new class of smart devices, equipment, and systems.
Okay, so Peter, can we step back a second? We have come a very long way in a relatively short amount of time when it comes to manufacturing technology, right? Where does Ethernet fit into the grand scheme of things?
Let's put it into context. We have obviously been making things since ancient times, but it's only in the last few hundred years, with the advancements in machines, materials, and power, that the more recent technological developments, including computers and the internet, have taken place. This has driven and enabled greater degrees of automated manufacturing, resulting in the development of the standards that we see in use today. And we'll see more new standards as the complexity of these processes increases.
So, Peter, when we're talking about industrial communication, there are a lot of different kinds of connector styles used today, right?
That's right. The explosion in manufacturing technology has created a huge variety of different industrial electrical connection interfaces, including power connectors and cables, to multi-contact signal connectors. One connector type that has been widely adopted for data signal transmission is the modular jack, or RJ45. First developed in the 1970s, specifically for telephone applications, RJ45 has expanded across many different applications, including for industrial equipment. RJ45s have been pushed to higher and higher limits in terms of speed and are now one of the de facto standards for many types of network equipment. But they are still limited in a couple of ways that can't really be changed, including their physical size and form factor, and other features such as their single-point latching mechanism, which is typically a plastic lever molded as part of the connector housing, not designed for rough handling. There have been a variety of versions developed for more rugged applications, which Amphenol also supplies, but we've reached the point where RJ45 connectors can no longer do the job for all next-gen applications, so new solutions are needed.
That makes sense. Now, what does the structure of data communication look like for a traditional factory automation setup today?
Well, it's helpful to understand how data communication within a manufacturing facility works to see how interconnect technology is used and why it needs to evolve. A typical manufacturing facility today has a number of functional layers, from the enterprise level at the top, where business planning, logistics, and all the other administrative functions take place, down to the factory floor at the individual component level, which includes sensors, actuators, motors, and other devices that actually do the work. In between these layers are increasing levels of device control, system and process control, and operations management. In the typical organization, Ethernet is already established as the protocol in the top levels. However, as we get down into the process control, device, and sensor levels, there are some distinct communication systems that have evolved, including various field bus protocols. And these don't necessarily talk to each other. While equipment on one level functions using one protocol, they are typically locked out of communicating with the next layer above or below without going through a protocol conversion process using devices called gateways. This results in additional equipment cost, can slow down data communication speed, as well as limit the scalability of a facility, limiting the ability to easily expand.
That makes sense. Now, an Ethernet-based factory automation setup would look different, right?
Yes, it would. With the transition to full Ethernet-connected factories, the limitations of the traditional model are removed. Because there is a single network operating with a single protocol using common interfaces, there are some key advantages. There's no protocol conversion required between layers, eliminating the need for expensive gateway equipment, reducing overall cost. This also reduces the data lag associated with the conversion process, enabling real-time data processing, expanding the scalability of the plant, and allowing devices to be added as needed. Every connected device is addressed using Ethernet protocol, enabling communication from all levels. Another advantage is that factories can be developed with a digital twin or a fully simulated process that mirrors the actual processes and uses data collected in real time to analyze and compare the actual performance against the designed process. In addition to providing the capability to design and simulate a process before physical implementation, the actual process can be monitored and adjusted to match the simulation, as well as adjusting the simulation to accommodate real-world equipment performance. Once this is fine-tuned, the digital twin can be used to both diagnose and predict issues, minimizing downtime and optimizing process flow. So to summarize, the hierarchical automation model uses independent communication systems at different levels, while the Ethernet model creates a single network in which all devices have IP addresses with the enhanced functionality that that enables.
Okay, so Peter, can we circle back to Ethernet in industrial applications? What kind of innovation are you seeing here?
Sure. To bring it back to an interconnect perspective and how this fits into the industrial model, I'd like to talk about some of the newest interfaces that have been developed for these applications. As I mentioned, RJ45 connectors have been adapted very successfully into the industrial space. They are very firmly entrenched and will continue to be for years to come. However, with their inherent limitations and the growing needs for reduced space and increased levels of performance, there are new interfaces addressing these limitations and offering significant advantages. The IX and single-pair Ethernet standards have developed with industrial Ethernet connectivity as their primary design criteria.
So, where would these new connectors fit into the overall industrial ecosystem?
Well, these products are taking their place in the new and Ethernet-based manufacturing model, while the large variety of existing industrial interconnects will continue to be used to some extent. The new data-driven industrial Ethernet automation model will benefit from the use of IX industrial and single-pair Ethernet.
So, Peter, what kind of benefits are we looking at here for these two interfaces?
Well, these two interfaces offer a number of key features and advantages. Their smaller form factor, ruggedized design, data performance, and signal integrity capabilities, support for powering devices over the data line, and key factors like being standards-based, and availability in IP20 and IP6X sealed configurations makes them ideal for industrial applications.
Okay, so Peter, size also plays a very important role in industrial applications, right? What do these two connectors buy me in terms of form factor?
Yep, that's absolutely right. When compared to the standard RJ45 connector, it's easy to see the size advantage of both IX and SBE. These are both about 75% smaller than the typical RJ45 in total space, volume, and footprint, enabling higher port density. The IP20 IX industrial can be placed on a 10 millimeter pitch, half of what can be done with an RJ, meaning you can double the number of ports in a typical multi-port application, such as an Ethernet switch.
Okay, cool. Now, Peter, can we also take a closer look at the cabling aspect of these two solutions?
Single-pair Ethernet only has two contacts for a single pair, or two-wire cable, whereas IX is designed to accommodate four pairs of wire for high-bandwidth Ethernet. Because single-pair Ethernet uses only two wires, the cabling is smaller and lighter, more flexible, and costs less, so it's easier and less expensive to run more cables to a lot of devices. IX Industrial supports four-pair or eight-wire Ethernet, enabling greater bandwidth, and the IX connectors actually have 10 contacts, so there are an additional two wires for power or other types of signals.
So, Peter, signal integrity is also crucial in industrial designs as well, right? What are we looking at here in terms of signal integrity?
Signal integrity essentially means to maintain accuracy of the transmitted information when it's received at the other end. It's crucial in any high-speed data network to ensure it operates properly. Both SBE and IX exceed the defined signal integrity performance standards for both insertion loss and return loss. Single pair Ethernet provides 1 gigabit performance up to 40 meters and 10 base T or 10 megabit performance up to 1 kilometer, while IX Industrial provides Cat 6A, which is 10 gigabit Ethernet, performance up to 100 meters. This makes IX perfect for high bandwidth, high speed data communications between levels in the manufacturing structure, while SBE is optimized to provide the necessary bandwidth and performance for individual devices such as sensors over a longer distance, supporting real-time, error-free performance in the network.
Now, both of these solutions can also provide power, right? Can we take a closer look at this aspect as well?
Yes, both SBE and IX can provide power to individual devices, eliminating the need for additional external power delivery. For SPE, this is referred to as Power Over Data Link, or PoODL, and IEEE standard 802.3CG specifies the delivery of 50 watts of power over cable lengths up to a 150 meter length and 1.2 watts up to 1 kilometer. IX Industrial is governed by the highest level of the standard, IEEE 802.3BT, or Power Over Ethernet++, specifying up to 100 watts of power using all four pairs over 40 meters of cabling. However, both single-pair Ethernet and IX Industrial have current ratings allowing them to exceed the maximum specified levels, meaning they're capable of even higher levels of power handling beyond the current 802.3 standards. The standardized mechanical interfaces and performance specs provide plug-and-play capability, simplifying servicing and addition of new devices in the network.
So, Peter, what are we talking about when it comes to performance here?
Well, both SPE and IX Industrial are governed by established IEC standards. Amphenol's products are fully interchangeable and can mate and function with products from other authorized manufacturers meeting the same standards. This ensures security of supply with multiple sourcing and reliable performance, in contrast to some other interfaces that are not as rigorously controlled or may not be standard interfaces.
Okay, so Peter, you also mentioned EMI earlier as well. What are we looking at here with these SPE and IX connectors?
Well, in order to provide optimal performance in an electrically noisy environment like a manufacturing plant, it's critical to make sure that sensitive data lines are properly shielded from radiated electromagnetic emissions. Both the SPE and the IX connectors feature fully 360-degree shielded designs, providing a completely protected connection through the mated interface. And the contact design of the IX with its low normal forces supports high mating cycles for a very durable, long-life interface. These features ensure superior EMI control, which is so critical to uninterrupted, reliable performance. Both SPE and IX feature IP20 fingerproof designs, meaning the contacts are recessed inside the connector so they cannot be touched in the unmated condition, protecting both the person handling the connector as well as the connector itself. The IP20 version is suitable for many applications on the shop floor as well as in protected environments, but for situations requiring a greater degree of protection from dust and fluid incursion, IP6X or IP65, 66, or 67 versions are also available.
Now, Peter, reliability is also critical in these types of applications. What do these solutions buy me as an engineer in this case?
Well, one extremely important feature of these industrial interfaces is the connector latching mechanism. Reliable latching is critical to ensure the connectors stay properly mated and avoid disrupting the signal, and it is also important that the latching features are rugged enough to withstand the potential damage or breakage. The standard RJ45 plug has a simple molded plastic latch, which is known to be weak and easily broken, making it unsuitable for applications which could see mechanical rough handling. In contrast, both SPE and IX plugs feature metal latching mechanisms, and the IX provides a two-point latch rated to 80 newtons minimum on latching force, ensuring reliable performance in critical applications.
Now, Peter, cable customization can be necessary in this field as well, right? Because you may need different lengths of cable for different applications. Can these two solutions help me here as well?
Absolutely. And it's important to be able to customize cables in the field when installing equipment, as length requirements can vary, so having field-installable plugs is valuable. Both the SPE and IX plug kits are available with integrated IDC, or insulation displacement contacts, which allow a cut wire to be terminated to the contact without stripping it. The connectors are designed to make it easy to trim and locate the wires properly for the IDC connection, with a special tool available to simplify terminating all the wires at once for the IX plug. Both IX and SPE also feature integrated cable strain relief mechanisms to make sure the terminations are protected from undue cable stresses. Amphenol also provides a variety of standard length cable assemblies and can provide customized length for specific applications. Cables can be provided with the same connector at each end and also in adapter styles, for instance, IX to RJ45. To facilitate integration of IX-equipped devices into a legacy system. Cables can also be provided in a pigtail configuration with the connector at one end but unterminated at the other, ready for a user to terminate themselves as needed. Another important feature of IX Industrial is the keyed housings to ensure connect mating in various applications. currently available with an A key or a B key, a C key is also planned. While the application of the A, B, and C keys is suggested by the IEC standard for different purposes, in fact, the connectors are identical from a performance standpoint, so any keying can be used for full Cat 6A 10 gigabit Ethernet applications.
Now, in these types of environments, dust and particle contamination can also be a cause for concern as well, right? Can the IX and SPE connectors help me in these types of situations as well?
Absolutely. In addition to the IP20 versions, there are also IP6X, IP65, 66, and 67 configurations of both IX and SPE available for the applications where protection against dust or particulate contamination are required, as well as against water incursion due to submersion or spray. The IX Industrial IP6X connectors feature a rectangular format with a push-pull latching plug housing, which seals and locks to a mating bulkhead mounted on the equipment panel. The equipment itself utilizes a standard IP20 PCB mount receptacle. Field terminable plugs are available, as well as pre-made cable assemblies, just like the IP20 versions. The SPE IP6X interface uses a circular form factor, the same size as an M12 connector, with a push-pull coupling ring to ensure a positive latch to the mating receptacles, which are panel-mounted, and all sealing is accomplished using internal O-rings. And SPE IP6X cables are also available in multiple configurations.
Okay, so Peter, what would a typical application look like?
Well, if we look inside a typical industrial control cabinet on the factory floor, we'd find devices inside such as programmable logic controllers, ports, switches, sensor controllers, power supplies, relays, vision system controllers, and all types of equipment depending on the application. In an Ethernet-based control system, all of these devices communicate with each other, and IX and SPE connectors and cables provide both the internal connections and the external I/O to all connected devices outside the box.
So beyond what you just showed me, Peter, what kind of applications would be a good fit for these types of connectors?
Well, the external devices that would be connected to the control cabinet can include a variety of different types of actuators, which provide physical motion, all types of sensors, controllers for drives, pumps, and more, human-machine interfaces such as displays and control panels, cameras used for vision systems and security, data loggers to provide measurement of various parameters, and robotics, which can take many forms from simple to very sophisticated. Many of these devices are self-powered with no external power source, so they rely on power being delivered through the single-pair Ethernet and IX industrial data connections using power over data link, or PoE.
Okay, now, Peter, transmission length and data rate are also important issues to take into consideration here as well, right?
They are. Ethernet protocol is well suited to the different types of devices and equipment being used at various transmission distances connected using new technologies like IX Industrial and SPE. Sensors and actuators used in factory and process automation environments, as well as in vehicular networks like trains and trams, running at longer transmission distances up to a kilometer, typically use less power and to have dedicated functions designed to work well at lower data rates like 10 or 100 megabits per second. SPE, with its power over data link capability, is an ideal connection interface for these applications. As data rate requirements increase and the link lengths get shorter, SPE functions up to 1 gigabit per second and can deliver even more power for devices like industrial PCs, displays, and motor drive controllers. And then, as data rates increase even further to 10 gigabit per second for more complex and higher power devices such as vision equipment and medical technology, IX Industrial provides the Cat 6A performance needed at power levels up to 100 watts. And the path to even higher data rates up to 100 gigabit per second will be enabled by future generation interconnects.
All right, Peter, can you recap your main points for me? Why should I consider Amphenol in particular for my next industrial Ethernet design?
Well, thanks, Amelia. I think the key takeaways are that Amphenol is committed to being one of the premier suppliers offering next-generation industrial Ethernet interconnect solutions using the most current designs, materials, fabrication, assembly, test, and quality processes. Amphenol has a strong product offering that is expanding to keep up with the rapidly growing industrial Ethernet market. You'll see more new interconnect products in this space in the future. Amphenol has a proven record of being first to market with products for evolving industry standards and technologies, and is anticipating future needs with more next-generation products. And Amphenol provides competitive pricing with shorter lead times and lower MOQs than our largest competitors. Our goal is simple. We want to be easy to do business with and provide solutions and services to our customers that enhance their own businesses and help to drive their success.
Excellent. Well, Peter, I think that's all I have time for today. Thank you so much for joining me.
Thank you, Amelia. Again, really appreciate the time and I look forward to it again. Take care.
And before we go, you didn't forget to click that link, did you? There you can find even more information about this topic from Amphenol. For Chalk Talks, I'm Amelia Dalton from eejournal.com. For more Chalk Talks, check out the Chalk Talks section of EE Journal. You can't miss it. It's right across the top. Or head on over to YouTube, youtube.com/eejournal.